Now I just want to introduce bicyclics. And I'm not going to rigorously teach you how to name them here, okay? In fact, I'm not going to teach you how to name them unless your professor specifically asks, okay? Because bicyclics are kind of like iffy. Some professors want you to know them, some professors don't. But I'm just going to teach you, no matter what, you should know the basics of what a bicyclic is, okay? And bicyclics are composed of two distinct rings attached along one bond, all right? So this would be an example of a bicyclic, and it's made out of two cyclohexanes. And the actual name for a bicyclic of two cyclohexanes is called a decalin. So decalin just equals cyclohexane bicyclic. Okay? Some professors also take a special interest in decalins, and I will also be monitoring your class to see if I have to teach a separate section on decalins as well. Some professors don't really care. Okay? What's important is that I just want you to know that a bicyclic, by the way, this dotted bond here is the same thing as a regular bond. I'm just pointing out that this is the bond that's shared. Okay, so that would be a bicyclic molecule. Okay, now a bridged compound is a type of bicyclic, and it's actually composed of three compound rings attached by what we call two bridgehead. I know this is getting a little weird. Bridgehead atoms, okay? So here's an example. This one's called norbornane, and it's a very common, this is actually one of the most common bridge structures. And you're asking me, Johnny, where are the three rings? I do not see three rings. Well, there actually are. There's this main thing down here that's actually just a weird way to draw cyclohexane. Okay, so that's just a six-membered ring. Then I've got a five-membered ring if I go along one side and then up like that. So that's one five-membered ring. And then it turns out that I have another five-membered ring if I go up the other side and up that thing. Okay? This thing in the middle that I keep pointing to is called the bridge. Okay? So it's like, I don't know, think about that you're like walking over a bridge and you're going from one side of the molecule to the other. The atoms that attach all of those are called the bridgehead atoms. So that's what I meant by two bridgeheads. So this is called a bridged compound. All right? So these are going to get, we have different ways of naming bicyclics. These have a certain way of naming, but like I said, that's going to be a separate section that I teach you only if your professor requires that you know that. I just want you to be familiar with what a bridge is. Okay? Awesome, guys. So with that said, let's go ahead and move on to the next topic.